In this video, I will show you how to test your Flutter app using Firebase Test Lab on multiple devices you don't own. Test Lab allows you to get the startup time of your app and the CPU usage, the frame rates, and also the memory and network consumption. The app that we are testing is a. Now let's talk about pricing. For the Sparkline of your Firebase project, you will get 5 test runs per day on physical devices and 10 test runs per day on virtual devices. But for Flutter apps, the virtual devices tests are not usable, as these tests require your app to be compiled to 86 binaries and Flutter doesn't support compiling to such format. And for the Blaze plan, you will get 60 minutes of test time per day on virtual devices and 30 minutes on the physical devices. And the billing starts with $5 per hour on physical devices and $1 per hour on virtual devices. To upload your APK for testing, we do have 3 options: the Firebase console, the Gcloud CLI, and CI/CD pipeline platform. We will use in this video Codemagic. And now with the first upload method, the Firebase console. First, we will have to build the APK for upload by the command flutter build APK. That way we have a production build, so our tests give us the most optimal results. Now go ahead to the Firebase console under the Testlab tab and upload your APK there. After the APK got uploaded, click continue and then click customize to choose your testing device. The recommended device for general testing is the Google's Pixel 5e, but there is also a huge collection of different devices with different Android versions to choose from. After you selected your testing device, choose the Android version, the language, and the orientation. Then click confirm to save your configuration. After that, go ahead and click start test. Generally speaking, the test will take several minutes to finish, but if any unhandled exception occurred, we'll stop the test. The testing will generate screenshots of your app and also provide you with a video of the whole testing process. But what we are most interested in is the performance tab. This tab contains information like the app startup time and the CPU usage and also the frame rates and the memory and network consumption. And now with the second upload method, the Gcloud CLI. First, we will have to install the Google Cloud SDK and make sure to grab the right binary for your system. And also make sure that you have Python 3 installed. After you have installed the SDK, run the install script inside the folder in your command line and follow the setup instructions. Now we will have to run the Gcloud Firebase test Android models list command to list all the available testing devices. This command will list out all the devices with their type, whether it's virtual or physical, and also their Android versions. To upload our APK, we will need to set the testing type to Robo and specifying our APK file path after the app flag, and also specifying the model ID, which is the testing device, and its Android version, its language, and its orientation. We can also set the timeout value, which is basically a way of telling TestLab to shut down the test if our app didn't respond within that time. After the tests have finished, we will get a URL to the console so we can inspect our results. The results contain the same information as the test performed directly from the console, and this method will allow us to upload and test our APK from a CI/CD platform build triggered by a code push from source repository. As we are going to see an example of this with the third upload method, Codemagic. First, we need to initialize Git on the root of our project and upload our code to GitHub. After that, go to Codemagic and create an application. After you created the application, go ahead and select your Git provider. We will be using GitHub for this project, then click Select Repository. Secondly, we will need to set the project type. In our case, that will be Flutter app. Then go ahead and select the repository that Codemagic will be listening to. For the build platform, we will be unselecting building for iOS as RoboTest is only available for Android. For the build trigger section, we will set the trigger on push on. That way, Codemagic will automatically start the build whenever we push code to our repository. And for the watched branch pattern is for setting a pattern for a specific branches to watch for code changes to start the build. By default, its value is set to an asterisk, which will watches all the branches in the repository. And the build section is where we set the parameters that affect the build process of our artifacts. We will set the Flutter CLI version to default, but you can set any version you want. And for the project path option is for setting the path to our application. It is now set to a period, which means the current directory. This option is useful if you have a monorepo and wanted to deploy a specific application, as you can specify its path here. And for the Android build format, make sure that you select APK. And set the build mode to release. And for the build arguments is for setting additional arguments like adding obfuscation to make it hard to reverse engineer your app binary. Codemagic gives us an environment for executing shell commands in various places in our build process. We will be using the post build script to upload our APK to Testlab with the Gcloud CLI. After that, we will be saving our changes. For the upload with the Gcloud CLI to work, we first need to open our Google Cloud project and enable a couple of APIs and create a service account key with the appropriate permissions. Go ahead and enable the Cloud Tool Resource API and also the Cloud Testing APIs. Keep in mind that these APIs have a limit quota. After you have enabled the API, go to IAM and Admin. And under the service accounts, go ahead and click create service account. Give the service account a name and then click create and continue. In this section, we will give the service account the permission that he can perform inside our project, like uploading our APK to Testlab. Generally speaking, it is considered a best practice to follow the least privileged principle, which is giving every service account only the permission that he need. That way will help minimize the damage on your project if those service account keys got compromised. For demonstration purposes, we will ignore this principle and give our service account the role of an editor. After that, click continue and done. Click on your service account from the list and under the keys tab, click add key, create new key, and then select the key type to be JSON, and then click create. After you downloaded the key, we need to encode it into a base64 string format by the following command. And copy this string and paste this as a value for the environment variable called gcloud file under the environment variable section inside Codemagic build config. Gcloud CLI will look for this environment variable for authentication whenever we upload our APK to Testlab, and then click Save Changes. After that, click Start Build. After the Codemagic build finishes, we will see the test results in the Firebase console. You will see that a RoboTest has finished, and with that, we finished our video as well. Expect another video soon about deploying server-rendered JavaScript apps to Firebase with one command.